Hello everyone, this side Alisha Bawa, currently working as an intern with Lexis and Company. And my today's topic of discussion is rights of an unborn child. You all must have heard what are the rights of a person, whether living inside or outside the country. But what about the rights of the person who is still in his mother's womb? That is rights of an unborn child. So to answer all your queries, we will be discussing this article today. So let us begin with our today's topic of discussion. Now, India is a democratic country. Every citizen in India is entitled to enjoy certain rights. That is rights from their birth, irrespective of what gender, caste or creed, etc. they belong to. Every citizen residing in the country is ensured with equality for all. But what about a child who is still in the mother's womb, that is about to take birth? Is he or she is entitled to any rights? There are many doubts and queries regarding their rights. So in this discussion, we shall discuss about the rights of an unborn child in India. There have been many conflicts and cases regarding the property rights of an unborn child. The legislative focus is aimed at a woman who chooses abortions. Despite there is no legislation or statutes that particularly defines the right and position of an unborn child. Now, several legislations defined it to be a legal person by fiction. Though the fact still lies that a child acquires his right after being born, the state hence requires to pay attention towards the abortion matters once the unborn child has reached the stage of viability. Now, right to life states that protecting right of a human being is important and therefore it needs to be protected. Now, the Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act states that all the necessary conditions and process of when and how a woman can get her child aborted and on what conditions. The law makes it very clear that despite a woman agrees for abortion, the abortion needs to be signed and agreed by a registered medical practitioner till 12 weeks of her pregnancy. Also, the registered medical practitioner should agree for abortion in between 12 to 20 weeks of her pregnancy. Now, let us discuss about what are the demerits of this act. The demerits of this act is that it does not acknowledge a large number of population who might be in need of abortion. And also, it does not give rights of choices and privacy that every mother should get. This is due to reason that the Act believes termination of pregnancies should be carried solely on medical reasons and nothing else. Now, Section 312 of the Indian Penal Code 1860 states that whoever causes a woman with child to miscarry with any evil purpose or say without the motive of saving the life of the mother shall be punished with an imprisonment which may extend up to 3 years or fine or both. But if in any case a woman or a mother causes miscarriage intentionally, then she will be punished with a punishment which may extend up to 7 years or fine or both. Now let us discuss about the property rights of an unborn child. There are still many confusions and debates regarding this topic. Can a property be transferred in the name of an unborn child? What if the owner of the property passes away before the birth of that child? So, Section 5 of the Transfer of Property Act states that a property can only be transferred to a living person. And hence, it does not allow the transfer of property in the name of an unborn child. While, on the other hand, Section 13, 14 and 18 of the same Act states that the law to transfer the property for the benefit of an unborn child. According to the Act, an interest has to be created to transfer the property in the name of an unborn child. which thereby means that a trustee has to be appointed for the benefit of the yet to be born child. Now, the interest should contain for the remaining interest in the property of the person who desires to transfer the property, or else the transfer stands cancelled. Now, according to section 13, which says that a property cannot be transferred to a non-existing person, and hence the expression for the benefit of is used instead of transfer to an unborn child. Under the Muslim law, there are no rights to the unborn child. Under the Muslim personal law, a gift to an unborn person is considered as void, except in the case of waqf. So to conclude this, I would like to say that, or it is really important to note that a child in mother's womb is considered to be an existence according to the law, and hence he or she enjoys having each and every right. So this was all about the today's topic, that is the rights of an unborn child. But if you have any queries regarding this topic, I would really happy to answer those queries. Do comment them in the comment section below. Thank you.